from historic Fenway Park in Boston. We've got the American League Championship Series on the show. It's the New York Yankees and the Boston Red Sox. With Chris Singleton, I'm John Ciambi. It's been quite a series so far, and the excitement's only ramping up as we get ready for Game 5.
Well, being down 3-1, calling it a do-or-die game is no exaggeration, but these situations tell us a lot about a team's character, and for some teams, it brings out their absolute best, but for others, it can kind of prove to be an overwhelming scenario to face, and so we'll see how they show up here today.
And we'll also get to see what kind of killer instinct they have on the other side. Some teams can get a little too relaxed when they're so comfortably in the driver's seat. All right, we'll be back to get this one started after this. Coming up and pitching in this game, Pedro Martinez.
A really good outing for him last time. Scattered two runs, was attacking hitters, getting ahead in the count. Great performance. We'll see if he can do it again in this one.
All right, ready to go here. And stepping in is the speedy Derek Jeter. And the pitch. On the ground. On to first. One up, one down. Very deep, not wanting anything over their heads. First offering misses the mark. Martinez, he's the kind of starter that a lot of pitching coaches and managers as well really appreciate. Not a guy who's going to get himself into trouble by dancing around, by walking guys. And now it's even up.
Yeah, he throws strikes, and you know he's got the command to be in the zone, be effective, but just moving the ball around, getting the ball back from the catcher booth, and throwing the pitch.
Swing and a miss. And a count 1-2. It's an interesting thing when you consider limiting walks. Is it more important today because of how many home runs are being hit?
No doubt. Keeping guys off the base paths with the way the swings and the launch angles are today, the emphasis of hitting home runs is so huge. It's never been more important.
Stepping in, Gary Sheffield. That one's in there, 0-1. Yeah, I think the other part, though, as well, is it goes both ways, because I think that guys at times are more than willing to give up walks because they'll come back and strike the next guy out. Next pitch is outside.
1-1.
And that's outside. Swing and a miss, and now 2-2. In the air, right field. Puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. Yanks nothing. Red Sox coming to bat. You're watching the American League Championship Series on the show.
Ninth inning, his last time out. Really wanted the complete game, didn't get it, but he did get the W. They'd love to see him pitch deep into this one again.
And here's the veteran outfielder, Johnny Damon. Chris, baseball today, so many strikeouts, and they are available to pitchers. But this is a guy that puts the bat on the ball and is kind of different from the players that we see day in, day out. Here comes the 0-1.
Yeah, his swing is so good. It's in the zone a long time. He gets the barrel to it a lot, and that produces more base hits.
0-2 now. Foul ball left side. He'll see another. Singy, one of the things that's interesting is that guys really don't worry about swing and miss from an offensive standpoint anymore. So when you see somebody who contacts the ball like this, do you think of that as plus value?
Absolutely. effective that is, running up pitch counts on pitchers and then either getting them to a place of fatigue or getting into the bullpen perhaps before you get to those higher leverage arms at the back end.
Next one misses.
Yeah, that's ball two.
One of the things that Jim Leland used to say when I was broadcasting with the Marlins, the longer a plate appearance goes for a batter, the more likely it is that something good will happen for the hitter. Sheffield makes the play. Two down.
Batting third, the left fielder.
Here's the left fielder, Manny Ramirez. That misses off the outside edge.
Yeah, and I figured you would get Kotze into this because you had a free dinner at his house the other night.
That is true. Swung on, belted. That's bad. Gone. His second home run of the series, and they jump out front. It's 1-0.
Versus power right there, like two locomotives colliding. Who's gonna win? Well, a really good job there by the hitter getting the top hand working. Powers that fastball out of here.
Now it's gonna be David Ortiz. Popped up to the left into foul ground. Rodriguez makes the catch, inning over. But they're off to a good start as they pick up a run on this solo shot. It's now 1-0. This is the American League Championship Series on the show. Rookie left fielder Hideki Matsui. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. Takes the turn. He's digging for second. Into second base. The tying run is on with a leadoff double.
Everything came together for him. First pitch fastball in a great spot to do some damage, and he squared it up nicely.
Now it's the veteran outfielder, Bernie Williams. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. No outs. Runner on second. Next pitch is popped up. Cabrera under this one. Makes the catch for the out. Righty delivers. That's a strike.
Man, that pitch was dotted. So much talent on display when this guy's out there on the hill.
Joe McDonald doing the home plate duties here.
Well, Joe is an interesting one. I'm always trying to figure out what exactly his zone is. Feels like he kind of moves around from game to game, sometimes inning to inning.
Hit weakly on the ground towards second. Gathers and throws to first. Now two out. Yeah, I think that's fair. I don't think he's ever way off with his balls and strikes, but yeah, I don't think it's easy to define what his zone is, like you said. Now it's the DH, Ruben Sierra. Strike two.
Man, he really sells the changeup with that arm action.
That just misses. 1-2 to count.
Boom, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Here comes a pitch. Swings and misses, struck him out. One hit, one left. We go to the bottom of inning number two. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Yankees nothing.
Cold night like tonight, last thing you want to do as a hitter is get jammed or even off the end, trying to find that sweet spot on the bat. Tell you what, you're going to be trying to catch things out front, so off-speed pitches may be a good complement to that fastball.
Up the middle, and it finds its way through for a hit. And the postseason success continues for him.
Seems like he got exactly what he was looking for right there. Timing on the swing was good, able to shoot the ball up the middle. Didn't square it up as much as he probably would have liked, but that's a good approach paying off.
And next for the Red Sox, number 33.
He's got pop, which is a little sneaky because he's so comfortable with taking his base hits to the opposite field, but he can jump you if you make a mistake.
The other way. Pulls it down and he makes the catch. Out number two.
Batting it, the third baseman, Bill Mueller.
Bill Mueller now at the plate. Obviously a guy who makes good contact, hits for average, but one of the things in today's game, the value in the fact that he hits both righties and lefties. In there and it's 0-1. They're so reliant on the matchups nowadays, Chris, and it's huge when you don't have to sit a guy or platoon him.
When you can hit, you know, both sides in terms of pitcher's arms, you're a guy that it's hard to take out of the lineup, and I think it's very important today when everything is under the microscope.
Here's a 1-1. And strike two. 1-2. One and two now. And a foul ball, he stays alive. In the air, out towards left center, pulls up and it drops for a hit. They stop the lead runner at second. Now two on with two outs.
He went up there and got it with two strikes. I'm not going to leave this in the umpire's hands. I'm going to be aggressive.
There for strike one. The pitch. And a pop up on the left side of the infield. Rodriguez makes the catch, and that'll do it. Boston strands a pair, but they're on top 1-0. The 1-2. Outside. Swing and a miss. Couldn't catch up to the heater.
Not the best location with the fastball on strike three, but when you're pumping high 90s, you'll get away with some of those. More margin for error. You know, the fastball has become such a huge strikeout pitch in the sport. I think a lot of it has to do with all the attention and emphasis on improved spin rates. These fastballs are just exploding out of the pitcher's hands and jumping through the zone.
One down, base is empty. Strike two.
Really consistent release point. He's been able to pitch up and down and have excellent command at both locations.
That one not close. It's a ball and two strikes. The pitch. Swing and a miss, struck him out. back-to-back strikeouts to start the frame, and that's now three in a row.
Yeah, he's really settling in and getting a feel for his pitches, throwing them where he wants to right now. So we'll see how long he can keep this streak going.
Jeter takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. And he grounds one to the right side. Gets it to first, and it's a 1-2-3 inning. Down in order, go to Yankees. They still trail 1-0. And he deals. Line drive, short hop to third. Fires to first, and they get the out. You got to be kidding me. Did you see that throw?
Not really, Boog. I mean, it happened in the blink of an eye, it seemed, but thankfully StatCast is here to help us out. I mean, you don't see many throws across the infield that get up into the 90s, so he really reached back for that one, and he had to get the out.
Now the number two hitter, Orlando Cabrera. He's 0 for 1. In for a strike, and it's 0-1. Cabrera, 27 years old, and he's a native of Colombia. Yoan. Comes up empty. That's strike two. Got it by him for the K.
Just blown away in that at bat. Three fastballs, all strikes. He wasn't even able to foul one off. There's not much you can take away from an at bat like that as a hitter other than maybe there's something wrong with your eyes. Got to have better timing on the fastball next time.
Ramirez in the box here lets that one go for a ball.
One ball, no strike.
That's in there. That's strike one.
Now just a cement mixer slider right there. It's a great pitch to hit if you can recognize it early and jump on it.
The 1-1 is fouled off. Righty to the plate. Right through there. Got him. And good work there as he gets a 1-2-3. Red Sox go down quietly, but they hold a 1-0 lead. In the air, right side. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. One away. So up next, Gary Sheffield. This guy makes great contact. One of the best in the game at putting bat on ball.
He's got such quick hands, and he's gaining pitch recognition. That keeps him square to the plate. There's a good chance that his bat stays in the zone a long time, and that produces solid contact consistently.
Out towards right center field, and that'll get down for a hit. So they get a man aboard with a one-out single.
I don't know how he's able to shoot that pitch the other way and still put something on it. That pitch was inside, and he let it get really deep. So pretty incredible hands to fight it off and still get good wood on it.
Sheffield, the runner at first with one gone in the inning. Diving, and he can't make the play. They get it in quickly. So first and second, now one out.
Wasting no time. He's 2 for 2 now on the night. And just a triple and home run away from the cycle.
Seriously, we're starting with this already. Two on, one out. Now it's the switch hitting outfielder, Bernie Williams. First time up was a pop out. And that's a strike.
Well, all eyes on the double play ball in this spot. No better way to get out of this inning.
Oh, one down. And a foul ball. Kicks and fires. Tapped softly on the ground. Over to second for one. Over to first. That's two. Nicely done. 1-6-3. And that will end the inning. Nothing across on two hits. No errors and a runner left. On now to the bottom of the fourth. It's the Red Sox 1 and the Yankees nothing. Afraid to show my teeth. You can never be like me. Yeah, I push until I bleed. And I keep it so 100. Yeah, I got some men. Swings and misses. It's a strikeout. Had him out front for strike three.
I mean, there aren't many curveballs in the sport today that break like that thing does. Huge movement. It's so difficult to get on the same plane and even think about squaring it up, let alone get a piece and hope he throws something else to keep the at bat alive.
Swing and a line drive, base hit out of the center field. So a man aboard now with one away.
Right there, does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
And now the right fielder, Nixon. And he's already singled in this game. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. The 0-1.
No, he's really working him away this at bat. Sometimes take a little bit off velocity, try to get a rollover, something on the ground, stay away from that big hole on the right side of the infield.
And here comes worm burner into the outfield for a knock. They fired in quickly, so it's first and second with only one away.
All over that one right there. Smash that one through the infield for the knock. When it's hit that hard, it makes it very tough on the infielders to make any sort of play.
Into center. Hauls it in for the out. So first and second with two outs. And stepping in for Boston, Bill Mueller.
Really good piece of hitting last time going to the opposite field.
And a good fastball to start him off at strike one.
Well, impressed that he went right after him on that first pitch. That's the key. Try to get ahead in the count, then you can play around a little bit more as the at bat expands.
The 0-1. Foul back our way, and that's out of play. Millar, the lead runner out at second. Nixon at first, two out of the inning. Line drive, base hit. Millar rounds third, headed for the plate. Clark with a relay throw. There's the tag. They get him, and that's the inning.
Well, this is what you've got to do. You've got to try to score on the two-out hit to the outfield, but outstanding execution on the relay home. Had to be almost perfect to make it close, and that's exactly what it was. Inning over.
And the righty deals. Swing and a pop-up. Foul territory for the catcher. Balls it in, and there's one away.
Got the pitch that he wanted. Just a little bit quick. Front shoulder open. Backside collapsed a little bit, and the launch angle not where he needed it to be.
And next for New York, Ruben Sierra. 0 for 1. He struck out swinging last time. That's a strike. It's 0-1.
If I'm at the dish right now, I am aggressive over the heart of the plate. This guy's been filling up the strike zone, so you know you're going to get a good pitch to hit. And as nasty as his stuff is, you might as well take all three swings.
And a couple of quick outs. And up next for New York, Tony Clark. Went down on strikes his first time through. There's a strike. That one missed. The wind of the pitch. And that's just foul. Right-hander kicks, deals. Cuts on it and misses. That's a strikeout. Couldn't catch up to the heater. Yanks held in check. Still behind by a count of 1-0. This one lifted in the air, left field. Matsui makes the catch. And there's one away. Back to the top of the lineup. Still stepping in for Boston, Johnny Damon. He's someone that you might not describe as having elite level speed, but he can absolutely move, and it is a factor in his game. That one fouled off.
This guy's definitely a plus runner, but what I love about him is that he goes all out every single time, never takes a break. It's guys like that, even though they don't have the elite speed, the fact that they're consistent with it, they make moves on the base paths.
The pitch. In the air, out towards right center. Hops over the wall, and that's an automatic double.
That was loud contact and a no doubt doubled off the bat. I didn't know it was going to land in the bullpen, though, and he's really improving his accuracy out there. It's almost like he tried to do it.
Runner at second here, one gone. Line drive, caught. Throw behind the runner, they've got him doubled off.
Contact. Some guys, they'll nibble just because they don't want to get hit hard. That's not what we're seeing here.
In the air, right field. And an automatic double now as it hops the wall and foul ground.
Well, this tends to happen more often in this park than others, and that short fence is just so inviting for hitters. You see a lot of balls bounce over for an automatic double when no one can run it down.
Derek Jeter will hit next. Swing and a ground ball up the middle. That's a base hit. Here comes the runner. Here comes the throw. But it's offline. He will score. We're tied at one.
Well, there you go. The RBI machine. Another clutch run scoring at bat.
Yeah, he's been so good in these situations. Call it clutch if you want, but his resume speaks. Pickoff throw. Jeter gets back easily. That's in there. And that's strike two.
with two strikes. May see some movement over there at first base, try to stay out of a double play here.
Swing and a miss, and he struck him out. And the struggles continue in the postseason.
Wow, just great bite to that slider. Broke hard out of the zone, and he just couldn't hold up the swing. You know, as a hitter, that pitch is really hard to take, and there's just not much you can do with it. You know that, but you don't want to get rung up by the umpire.
Gary Sheffield stepping in now for the Yankees. 1-for-2. Martinez checks on first, and he's back in easily. In the air to left center. Dives, but it kicks off his glove. And he's got a double. Now here's an easy out with a pair of runners stranded. Boston's bullpen with some activity. Number 50 appears to be getting ready. And I'm sure he's feeling some nerves. This would be his major league debut. Number 43 getting cranked up as well. That misses. Two balls, two strikes.
This guy's seen two changeups in a row. Could be a little vulnerable for a fastball right here.
Here's a 2-2. Stays alive.
He's mixing his pitches really well. Late on that fastball after seeing the changeup. See if he can elevate one. I think if he does, he'll get the swing and miss.
Out to short. Fires across the diamond. That's out number 3. But they pick up one run on the RBI single. All even at one apiece. That one is lifted in the air. And in one hops the wall. And that's a double.
Putting some good swings on the ball. That's his second extra base hit in this one. Put a really nice balanced swing on it. And when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box. And he'll feel real good about that one. A chance now to take the lead. And at this point in the game, that could be a deciding run.
So now here's the DH, David Ortiz. There's the strike. Runner at second, nobody out. Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Pretty impressive. We haven't seen that pitch from him much, but he's got a really good feel when he throws it.
Next offering is fouled back. Runner leads away at second. That one is absolutely belted. That's down. One hops off the wall. The run comes in to score from second. It's 2-1. Pulls into second. That's an RBI double.
Still able to come through behind in the count right there. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Gets the call. Gonna count 1-2. And the right-hander deals. Sharp grounder. That's through for a base hit. Ortiz around third. Here's the throw to the plate. The run comes in from second, and they lead by 2.
picks himself up an RBI. I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
Nixon, the next to hit. Runner on the goal. Fly ball down the right field line. If it's fair, it's gone. And that is gone. That's what the fans came to see. That's his third home run of the series. And they throw a pair on the board. It's 5-1. He only needed one swing to square it up.
Not wasting any time in that at bat, Boog. Aggressive, and it paid off. Well, I'm not really sure how he kept that fair. When you're out in front on a breaking ball like that, such a good chance that it's going to hook foul, but not this time. He kept the hands moving.
The 0-2. Left field. And there's one down. And stepping in for Boston, Bill Mueller. Anything in particular stand out to you as far as moments at Fenway Park?
Wow, you know, it's unfortunate because I remember as an Oakland A's player, we were up in the series against the Red Sox, 2-0. All we needed to do was close out a Saturday night ball game. We went extra innings. The Red Sox won that ball game. And then Sunday, they pushed the series by winning game 4 back to Oakland for game 5. And unfortunately, they won game 5 as well.
0-2 now. Fights it off, you'll see another. That was 2003, and the Red Sox would eventually get their hearts broken by Aaron Boone, but end the curse a year later. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Makes the grab, 2 down.
The batter, number 12.
And now it's the switch hitting second baseman, number 12. Smoked on the ground a second to first, and that's the third out. So they move out in front after a 4-run outburst. Game 5 moves to the 7th inning now. It's the Red Sox 5 and the Yankees 1.
And this guy is someone you can believe in to find a way to get on base.
3-2 now. The wind of the pitch. Ripped on the ground a second. The throw to first. 2 up, 2 down.
Fastball grooved right down the middle. Usually a lot of damage done with that pitch. A hard grounder, but he wanted to get that ball in the air. Maybe drive it into the gap.
2 outs. Base is empty. Ruben Sierra stepping in now for the Yankees. And ball one. High fly ball out of the left center field. Damon tracks it down for the out. So the Yanks go in order. They're down 5-1. And now the lefty just misses the mark outside the zone.
It's a good take.
That one ripped. High bounce over the fence for an automatic double.
Well, there's something really nice about getting yourself an automatic double like that. You get to stroll into second base without having to worry about a throw or getting your uniform dirty. And now you're just looking for the next guy to kind of do the same thing. Maybe put one in the gap so you can jog home as well.
Next to hit, Orlando Cabrera. Next offering popped in the air, right field. Squeezes it, and there's one away. Manny Ramirez now at the plate. He's already homered in this game. He's a guy who does it all. With the lack of contact in today's game, this guy hits for contact, so he delivers average, but there's on base and slugging too. And first offering is fouled off.
Early in the count, you have to be real careful because of that power, but then if this hitter gets a strike or two on him, he's still very comfortable. And because he has the ability to get the barrel to the baseball, he's a threat deep into the count as well.
Damon over at second, one down. Next offering is fouled back. The 0-2. Line drive. That's a base hit. Into third now, so runners at the corners and one out.
Well, he found himself behind in the count right there, but he didn't give in. Nice line drive to the pull side, met it out front, but just stayed through it nice enough and ripped it into the outfield.
And now the DH, David Ortiz.
RBI knock for him last time, now a chance to drive in another run.
That's in there. Strike one. That one lifted to left. And it one hops the wall. In comes the runner from third. It's 6-1. And in its second with an RBI double.
Take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Next pitch has popped up. And there's two down.
Well, that's a frustrating at bat right there. Big opportunity and just missed it. I know he wanted to do some damage. Next guy will have to pick him up.
And now here is Nixon. He's already homered here in this one.
No matter what, you're playing this kind of rival, take your game to another level.
First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
There it was. Oh, here it is. Hit it. He gets a take, gets ahead in the count.
The 0-1. Check swing, now an appeal to third. And Freddie Ferguson says he went around. Gets a piece there, we'll do it again. Left-hand batter waits. Swing and a miss. Struck him out. Good job at damage control right there. Two men left stranded, but they do push across one. We look ahead to inning number 8. It's the Red Sox 6 and the Yankees 1. And a foul ball. Red Sox up 6-1. Ground ball up the middle. Fires over to first. Two up, two down here in the top of the 8th. Back to the top of the Yankee order. Derek Jeter stepping in now for the Yankees. And first offering is fouled off. In the air out to center. Damon drifts towards it. He's got it. And that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Yankees. The lead remains 5. It's 6-1.
Guy with a big arm like that behind the plate, it really shuts down the running game.
And a seed into center. That's a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
I'm sure he feels really good about that one. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride and load out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
Man at first, and now it's switch hitting third baseman Bill Mueller. Oh, and the zone doesn't get the call. And that's ball one. And another ball.
When you have a catcher that can throw like that, a pitcher doesn't have to worry as much about the slide step. He can keep his mechanics intact and have a better opportunity of getting that hitter out with a swing and miss.
Runner at first with no outs here. On a line, base hit. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages.
On the ground. And it gets by him. Swing and a ball ripped out towards right center field. That'll touch down for a hit. One run is in. Two runs across now. And they clear the bases. Three runs score, and it's an 8-run lead. Into third as the triple clears the bases.
Love how he let that ball travel, trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Runner at third with one gone. Now the left fielder, Manny Ramirez. He's got the power, but great contact skill. Swing and a high fly ball to left. Matsui makes the catch. Runner tags from third. That's a sacrifice fly as he comes across. It's 10-1.
Man, there's a sac fly to bring home another run in this inning. These guys are just piling it on. We're seeing some really quality at-bats out of this team right now.
Next is the designated hitter, David Ortiz.
Well, I think that pitch surprised all of us. Right down the middle, doesn't get a swing. Not very often you see a hitter lay off a cookie like that.
That one pushed foul, out of play off to the left.
Well, he missed a hittable off-speed pitch right there. Not sure exactly with the timing. Sometimes you get a backup breaking ball. You're expecting it to make its move at the end.
Well, looked at the fastball for strike three there to end the inning. Four runs in the inning, four hits, no errors, and no one left. We're on to the ninth now in game 5. It's the Red Sox 10 and the Yankees 1. Foul ball there. Here comes the 0-1. puts it in the air out towards left center. Flashes the leather on the running catch. And there's one down. Gary Sheffield stepping in now for the Yankees. Singing, you can't ask for anything more. This guy checks all the boxes offensively.
He is the ultimate professional, and it doesn't just start at game time. It starts in the afternoon, the way he prepares and gets ready for the ball game.
This one swung on and hit well, way back there. And it's off the wall. Throws to second. It's a double, third hit of the night for him.
Put a pretty good swing on that one as he drove it out to deep left. Didn't quite have the right combination of launch angle and exit velocity to get it over the fence, but you're never going to be disappointed with extra bases.
That's towards center. Damon in pursuit. Makes the grab on the run. Runner tags at second.
Was able to move the runner up to third on that deep fly to center, but I think this point he wants to get him over and get him in.
So digging in, Bernie Williams.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
And there's the strike.
Some guys are just more confident they can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
Right-hander kicks, deals. That's out to center field. And he'll put it away. Ball game. And the Red Sox slug their way to a win in this one.
In an elimination game, you see your season quickly coming to an end. It can be a bit nerve-wracking, but they were able to settle things down, come out and play really good baseball in this one. They get the win, and the series continues. Who knows? Maybe they'll get right back in it.
So, Singy, as the numbers show, a great performance on the mound in this one.
Absolutely, and that really set the tone from the beginning. A fantastic effort.
10-1, the final score. For Chris Singleton and our entire outstanding crew here at MLB The Show, I'm John Ciambi saying so long.